Hey everybody, this is Nick, and today we're going to make a unit chart in PowerPoint. A unit chart is kind of like an icon array. It's a graphical representation of the number of people in some sort of data set. So in this case, I really like using unit charts when I have a program evaluation of a very small number of participants, when maybe I don't want to use percentages in a chart because my numbers are really small, but I want to show the reader how each individual in my sample rated their experience. So you can see the bar chart on the left. That's just a traditional bar chart. We could use that very effectively in any of our program evaluations. It shows accounts, not percentages. So 15 people rated their experience outstanding, 10 people excellent, etc. The chart on the right is a unit chart. Each circle represents one person. This is how they each rated their response here in the data. I think it's kind of a little fun way to represent some of these data, and it kind of eliminates that sort of bar chart fatigue that we might get. So I'm gonna go ahead, escape out of this slide, and we're gonna make one from scratch right here. So let's go ahead over to my screen. Here's my bar chart right here. What I'm gonna do is we're just gonna make the unit chart right from the bar chart, and all we need to do in PowerPoint first is insert the circle. So let's go up to the Insert tab. We're gonna go to the Shapes menu and then insert a circle right here on the platform. It doesn't really matter what size because we're gonna do some resizing of the chart in general anyway. So the first thing I wanna do is format the circle. You need to format the circle in the exact way that you want it to show up in your chart. So right now, I'm just gonna keep it this blue fill. And I'm going to do this just to show you an example here. I'm going to keep the outline also blue. So let's go ahead and we're going to actually copy the chart. You could push Control C or right click to copy, and then go ahead to your bar chart and just highlight the series of data in your chart. And now we're going to paste. We're just going to either push Control V to paste or right click. And actually you can't right click and paste here. So what we're going to do is click on that series of bars, and then we're going to push Control V to paste. So Control V, and now you can see that it has actually pasted something inside those bars. It's a really big, long, stretched circle. So what we need to do is over on the Format Data Series menu here, go over to that paint bucket icon. That's where we always update the colors and the fill colors. And you can see right here, picture or texture fill has been selected because we've filled the bar with some sort of a picture or a shape in this case. And now what we need to do is scroll down here. You can see that there are some options here for how the bar chart wants to treat that picture or texture. And right now it's defaulted to stretch, but what we're going to do is say stack and scale width. If we say stack and scale width, that's going to give the exact number of images for the data that we have in each of those bars. So now we have 15 circles, 10 circles, 4 circles, etc. Now you can also see that there are some things here that I don't really like. The circles are still sort of stretched. They're kind of squished up above. So what we can do here, you could go ahead and, you know, drag the chart or resize the chart like this manually to get sort of the shape that you want. The other thing that we can do is we can manipulate the gap width. So let's go ahead and click on our series of bars over in the Format Data Series menu. Under that bar chart icon there, that's where we adjust the gap width. That means the gap between the bars. So right now it's set to 100%. Let's just go ahead and increase it and see what that does. Now you can see that actually makes the circles a little bit better and more proportionate right there. So it's actually increasing the gap width between the bars in order to do that. So that's one way that you can kind of manipulate that. The other thing that I don't know if I really like is you can see, if you look really closely at these bars, they are really touching each other. They're kind of butting up against each other here. We can manipulate that or change that by putting a white outline around our circle. So let's just go ahead over to our circle right here, and I'm going to go ahead to the Shape Format menu, and under the Shape Outline, we're going to go ahead, instead of a blue outline, let's go ahead and click a white outline. Now I'm also going to, under the Format Shape menu, we're going to also adjust the line weight of that border. So under Solid Line, you can see that we have a white color. Under the Width, it's 1.5, but I'm going to go up to maybe 3. Let's go to a 3-point white outline around that circle. Now all we have to do is copy this circle again and paste it back into our chart. So I'm going to go ahead and Control C to copy. We're going to go over to our chart and push Control V to paste. And now you can see that each circle has that nice little white outline around it. A pretty cool trick and a really nice sort of effect, I think, to tell your reader that you have a pretty small sample size in this program evaluation, and you want everybody, you want your readers to know how each individual in your program responded to the the ratings. So if you like this video, go ahead, give it a thumbs up. Make sure to hit that subscribe button and the bell next to it. You'll get notified every time I post a new video in data or information design, usually Excel or PowerPoint tutorials. I hope you all had a great time watching. I had a great time making this for you, and I can't wait to see you all next time.